So this question is about an AR1 model. Now that first part isn't really a question, it's just a statement. Here's our AR1 model for set t, which is a function of set t minus 1, and you can see our constant and our AR1 coefficient. From that you know that you can calculate the unconditional expectation of set t as the constant divided by 1 minus the AR1 coefficient, and that of course is equal to 1. So if you don't know anything else, we expect this value to take a value of 1. Now, however, we are asked to calculate conditional expectation, conditional on it minus 1, so that's all conditional on all information that is available at time t minus 1. So let's start with the expectation of set t given information at t minus 1. So let's replicate the operations operator, including the conditioning information. And now all we do is we'll replace set t with our process equation. So 0.2 plus 0.8 times set t minus 1. So we have set t on the left-hand side, so we can just use everything on the right-hand side, which is equivalent. The constant coefficients we can get out of the expectations operator, so we get 0.2 plus 0.8 times the expectation of set t minus 1 conditional on set it minus 1 plus the expectation of ut conditional on the information set it minus 1. So let's replicate the coefficients first. The question is now, what is this? The expectation of set t minus 1 at time t minus 1. Now, of course, at time t minus 1, we know what set t minus 1 is. That's 0.9. So lastly, the expected value of ut given information at t minus 1, that's a random term, so the expected value of that is 0. Altogether, we get here a value of 0.92. So the conditional expectation of set t given information at time t minus 1 is 0.92. Let's move to the two-step ahead forecast. Expected value of set t plus 1 given information at time t minus 1. So we're having two time periods difference here. We'll follow exactly the same procedure. We'll replicate the conditional expectations operator, and we replace for set t plus 1 our process equation, but now we have set t on the right hand side, because we are having an AR1 model, so we are having observations of one period difference. And otherwise, we replicate the conditional expectations operator. Again, we can take the constant parameter values outside, so we have 0.2 plus 0.8 times the expected value of set t given information at time t minus 1. Plus, again, an error term, ut plus 1, but the expected value of that given information at t minus 1 is going to be 0 again. So really what we're having here is the expected value of ut plus 1 given information at time t minus 1. So let's replicate these coefficients again, 0.2 plus 0.8 times, and now we need this guy here, this guy which is highlighted in blue, but that's of course exactly what we calculated before. The conditional expectation of set t given information at time t minus 1, it turned out that was 0.92. So we'll take that value which we calculated in the first step, and we use it here for the two-step ahead forecast. If you do the calculations, what you get is 0.936. So in this pattern will now repeat. We're being asked to calculate two more forecasts. So now we're going to a three-step ahead forecast, expected value of set t plus 2 given information at time t minus 1. And I'll make that just somewhat shorter. We can see the pattern, 0.2 plus 0.8 times the expected value of set t plus 1 given information at time t minus 1, plus an error term, expected value of an error term, which is 0. So now we need that yellow bit here, but of course that is exactly what we again calculated in the previous step, and the outcome of that was 0.936. So we shall use 0.936 in our three-step ahead forecast. And doing the calculations, we receive a value of 0.9488. So, last step, we want to calculate the expected value of set t plus 3, still at the same, given the same information set, only using information available at time t minus 1. So it's a four step ahead forecast, but the same pattern, 0.2 plus 0.8 times the expected value of set t plus 2, given information at time t minus 1. So we have 0.2 plus 0.8 times, now we need that conditional expectation. This is a three step ahead conditional expectation, and that is exactly what we calculated in the previous step. The result here was 0.9488, so this is what we use in our four step ahead forecast calculation. And the result here is 0.95904. So in this next part of the question, we're being asked whether the process described in the previous part of the question is a weakly dependent process. So let's replicate the process here. It's an AR1 process with AR1 coefficient 0.8 and a constant of 0.2. Now, you should of course remember from your studies that the condition for this process describing a weakly dependent process is that the absolute value of that AR1 coefficient is smaller than 1. That's of course true. So this is a stationary and weakly dependent process. We also asked to use the results in the previous answer to shed some light on that question, whether this is weakly dependent. And perhaps the easiest way to do that is to draw a little graph in which we plot, for starters, our last observation and the conditional forecasts which we calculated in the previous question. Of course, you know that we started with a value at time t minus 1 of 0.9. That was our last known value. But then we also had forecasts at time t, and here we had calculated a conditional one step ahead forecast of 0.92, and then further slightly increasing values for time t plus 1, for time t plus 2, and for time t plus 3. Now, time t plus 3, the value of the conditional forecast was about 0.96. Right, just slightly below 0.96. So let's show another value in this graph, the value of 1, and I'll just show this as a line that we had previously calculated as being the unconditional expectation of that particular AR1 process. And you can see that our conditional expectations, as we go more and more step ahead, converge to this value of the unconditional expectation. And that's a feature of a weakly dependent process, certainly if that convergence goes quickly enough. So by eyeballing this, this is quite quick in this particular process, and therefore we come to the conclusion that this is a weakly dependent process. Of course, what is quick and what isn't is somewhat of a difficult question, and there is no hard boundary which we can describe in terms of as a visual guide when looking at such graphs. The last part of this question takes a slightly different tack. We are being told that for a particular time series yt, that the first order autocorrelation is 0.78, second order autocorrelation 0.65, and third order 0.52. And now the question is, if we estimated an AR1 model on this type of process, what would we find for the AR1 coefficient? So here's our AR1 model. So the question is, if you had these sorts of data, what would you find gamma 1 to be? Or what estimate for gamma 1 would you obtain? Now, you've learned that There's a relationship between the first order autocorrelation, rho 1, and that coefficient, gamma 1. So first order autocorrelation is the correlation between yt and yt minus 1. And in an AR1 process, but only in an AR1 process, that shall equal to gamma 1, our AR1 coefficient. So it means in our case, we would obtain an estimated value for gamma 1 of approximately 0.78. We'll just use that value of 0.78 exactly for the remaining of the question. Now, once we know this, once we have a particular value for gamma 1, gamma 1 hat, we can use that value to infer what higher order autocorrelations this particular AR1 process implies. Okay, now of course higher order autocorrelation means the correlation, for instance, between yt and yt minus 2. In an AR1 process, we of course know that that second order autocorrelation ought to be equal to gamma 1 hat squared. And in our particular case, that would mean 0.78 squared, and that is equal to 0.6084. What about the third order autocorrelation, rho 3? In an AR1 process, that is described by gamma 1 hat cubed. And the result of this is 0.47455. So now, to answer the question, we basically need to compare these implied for second and third order autocorrelations of 0.6084 and 0.47455 with the values which we know to be correct from the data. That's the ones in the question, 0.65 and 0.52. So the question is, how similar are these two sets of higher order autocorrelations? In some sense, they seem quite close. Now, whether these are really close or not, without any further guidance, you can't really say. But it is possibly fair enough to say that this AR1 model seems to fit the autocorrelation function, or ACF, of the observed data fairly well.